There's something special about the Ubiquiti community. They are ravenous in their search for more info, vicious in their criticism, and fanatical in their following of everything Ubiquiti. Some have been around since the way beginning, when Robert left Apple and started Ubiquiti out of his studio apartment. Some have left and then returned as the product line has evolved and changed over the years. And some are like me, who've been around for several years, who have learned from everybody who's come before us, as well as our friends in the community. Some of you are just discovering Ubiquiti now. Congratulations and welcome to the club. One thing we have always done is posting photos from the wild. Like a celebrity sighting, Ubiquiti fans are folks who walk into a room and quickly scan around looking for access points and cameras in the ceiling and corners around the space so that they can point out, usually to their spouse who quite often doesn't get it, that this place runs on Ubiquiti. Or, look how terrible that mounting job is, I could do way better. I can't wait to post this on Reddit or the Facebook group and watch everybody lose their minds. The ubiquitous Ubiquiti UFO has changed somewhat over the years, but it's always reaching out to us like a beacon in the darkness with its glowing blue ring. Or, for the real OGs in the audience, a glowing green ring, which was on the earlier access points. Today, that changes again. Ubiquiti has taken the wraps off the next generation of Ubiquiti access points. The new portal to the information superhighway, flattened and strong, built to last with solid metal backings and still that glowing blue reassuring light shining down on us. Will this design trickle down to the rest of the lineup? That remains to be seen. On the Enterprise APs, that design is all squircles, so really, I have no idea, but I would love to see this trickle down to the rest of the Ubiquiti access point lineup. The flat dish and sharp corners very much looks professional and next generation. You may have noticed that Ubiquiti has been making inroads in the enterprise space with their new enterprise AP lineup. They have an excellent understanding of the space and, quite frankly, an unbelievably incredible testbed in the form of the FedEx Forum, which is home of the Grizzlies basketball team, which happens to be owned by Ubiquiti's founder, Robert Pira. They set out to build incredible hardware and software which would incorporate the needs of much larger customers, such as the FedEx Forum at the stadium level, and universities and beyond. I'm honestly not sure that there is a better test case when you're looking to push the boundaries and stress the environment of Wi-Fi than an arena. They generally had to contend with thousands and thousands of people showing up all around the same time, moving around the stadium, and uploading and downloading, consuming, in general, a tremendous amount of information. When they set out to begin building their enterprise lineup, they went back to the drawing board, wiped it clean, and said, let's start fresh. And they asked themselves, how do we design the best possible enterprise access point? In doing so, they pushed everything to the limits, including power, throughput, management, heat dissipation, and more. All of these designs came with significant learnings, which are now being brought down to more access points. You've seen the enterprise lineup, now meet the XG lineup. I have here the U7 Pro XG and XGS access points. As mentioned before, they have an all-new design featuring a flat face, sharp sides, all-metal backing, and a 10 gigabit Ethernet port on both of them. I've been playing with them and testing them out for a little while now, and I have to say I am impressed. They are both Wi-Fi 7 APs. Yes, they come with 6 gigahertz support, a single 10 gigabit uplink, fanless, and now, for the first time ever, I think ever, come in two colors, traditional light and the all-new dark mode black. In the lineup, I would say that they fall between the Enterprise APs and the Pro Max APs. The difference between these is that the U7 Pro XG has 6 spatial streams covering over 1,500 feet for over 300 clients. The XGS, however, has 8 spatial streams, can cover an area over 1,750 square feet, and can handle over 500 connected clients simultaneously. The XGS also has a dedicated spectral scanning radio. They're supported by a briefly teased new lineup of XG switches, complete with 10 gigabit ports with PoE++ and PoE++ configurations, as well as Ether lighting, and even has a desktop compact 8-port PoE XG switch. The other switches in the lineup are rack-mounted 16, 24, and 48-port switches. Now let's get the XG set up here in the studio and throw some things at it and see what it looks like when it's all booted up. I'm going to take out the little chip over here so that I have easier pass-through for my longer Ubiquiti cable ends. Pop it into the end there, and yes, of course, these do bend, so if I wanted to, I could bend that a little bit so that it would fit more flushly. Is that a word? Flushly? I guess. More flush. And then later when we're done testing here, we can go over to our friends at the Long Beach Beer Lab where I have filmed before and get one of these installed and look at it in a production environment. They regularly have large events with lots of customers from trivia to Oktoberfest where they need to have a lot of capacity for everybody who is connecting and utilizing their devices as well as all of their terminals in real time. All right, let's get this plugged into the rack. I've got my test rack behind me. Now remember that this is capable of being plugged into a 1 gigabit, 2.5, or even 10 gigabit port. I'm going to plug it into a 10 gigabit port on the switch right here. The switch that I'm plugging it into is the USW Pro HD24. You can see the ether lighting is going to show up in a moment. I believe it should turn purple, but I don't know if I have that configured at the moment. And as usual on the AP, you have your beautiful LED booting up there, flashing white. It's adopting usual fare, access point U7 Pro XG, IP address, etc., etc. And see, we've got that nice glowing purple behind us on the cable. Let's give it a minute to update. We've got our update going as that's flashing blue and white. Okay, looking good. We've got your send and receive retries, your clients, which obviously is nothing at this point, your model, IP address, MAC address, device version, Wi-Fi names that are broadcasting off of this AP, your uptime, memory usage, load average, AP group, etc. And you'll notice that this is on the 10 gigabit Ethernet speed, which is fantastic, and it is only drawing 9 watts. I'm over in the Wi-Fi Man app now, and we're going to do a quick speed test and see what this thing can do. 1200, 13, 14, okay, looking good. Not bad, should be closer to 2 gig, given that I have a 2 gig fiber line here, but I'm also not the only one on the network, and there are other people using it, so this is a to-be-expected speed. Now let's go over to the signal test here, and you'll see that my signal strength is obviously very strong, and if we hit throughput, we'll see what the physical throughput capabilities are here. Looking, we're getting about what we were on the speed test. 1500, so it's definitely higher. It's kind of bouncing around there a little bit. One of the other things I like to do is to go in the Wi-Fi Man app and tap on my gateway, and then do a speed test directly between my device and the gateway to see what kind of speeds we can get out of it. Right now it looks like we're doing 1500 down. And 14, do I see 15? Almost 1440 up, I believe it was, 1448 up and 15 down. All right, we're back at my clients, the Long Beach Beer Lab. Thank you so much for letting me continue to experiment and film on your wonderful facilities over here. Flipping it around, we've got a Nano HD, old school. The old Nano HD, which was mounted on top of the beam here and has been supplying Wi-Fi, but as we've been upgrading them to the newer 2.5 gig speeds and faster internet, time to get some real upgrades going. So we're gonna be putting this, where's the cable? Right over here. We'll put this right on the beam like so. Just line it up in the right angle. Looks like right over here is where we're gonna go. Apologies if my audio is terrible. I forgot the microphones again because I ran out of the house quickly to get this done in time. Because that's how embargoes work sometimes. Alrighty, let's see what the best way to mount this is. Looks like we've got screws on both sides towards my cable. Run it through like so. Not a whole lot of room there to work with, but we're gonna make it work. Let's get this guy clipped in here. The U7 Pro XG costs $199 and the U7 Pro XGS costs $299. Both devices are available today. If this video was helpful to you and you do make a purchase, I'd appreciate it if you used my affiliate link, which is down below. Please leave your questions and comments down below. I do my best to see every single one of them and respond to as many as I can. And as always, thanks for watching.